me they were just awful from the line.
Yes, the Toyota team is shooting 71% from the floor, which is not bad if you only took 10 shots. But they've taken 24 shots. They've missed 7 from the free throw line.
That experience from Toyota, the team bond was just a disaster, and the Cesar increasing the lead now to 3 points. There's a cut by Abekin pulling up. King joining hands with Juan Fernandez. Juan has got 30 points and 23 by Abe King. Here is Kidaben, is playing four personnel fouls, so looking for room. Getting the basket, putting it up.
Somehow you wonder why he was not doing that the entire evening.
Here is Arnaiz. Being hounded by Fabiosa, the big J. Juan Fernandez with a shoulder move. And he got shot.
With 32 big points.
Made 20 during the first half, but what's great about Juan Fernandez is pulled down 13 rebounds, 10 and 3. Here is Akoykon, nobody there to pick him up. Right away from Julius Wayne.
That's the 14th point of Akoykon, and he's had opportunities to score. I think they're going to have to look to Akoykon for the rest of this ball game.
We have 9 and 45 to go. It's a 3-point game being enjoyed by Crispa. It's 90-87. Bates on Andre King. Bates is playing his 2 personal fouls. Moves it closer, and he is fouled in the act of shooting by Akoykon. That's the fourth of Akoykon. Crispa is now with 2 personnel, 20 fouls, none on Toyota. Wayne is pulled out by Edo Campo. We have Blau right back.
Well, this is a good substitution by Edo Campo. Julius Wayne had not gone to the bench the entire ball game, and he doesn't want to have a tired Julius Wayne on the court with 3 or 4 minutes to go on the ball game. So Julius will probably sit on the bench for 2 minutes now.
Well, Julius Wayne, aside from making 10 points for Toyota, has pulled down 5 rebounds, and he's got 2 personal fouls. Warning on Bates. Better behave and looks down. The morning Van Christian. Big draw, big attraction here to PBA.
Julius Bates has been, very quiet this evening. I'm not talking about his point production, but also in his temperament. He has not losing his hands in the air, the usual signs that Leroy Bates gives after a nice play.
Leroy Bates had 51 points, 11 rebounds during their first meeting, May 29th. And Thomas Keenan by Cesar, quick hands, and ball going back to Cesar. 11 for Philip Cesar, made only 5 during the first half of play. Here's Juan Fernandez, lead it to stall, halfway call for Crispa. Going to Fabiosa. In and out, but the other was there, still nothing. Fabiosa keeping it alive. No foul shot. No foul. Rugged play. Blau. Fabiosa down by 3. Blau gets it down to 1.
Blau having a lot of confidence from the outside.
So far, Blau has contributed 7 points, made only 3 during the first half, another 4 here in the second half, 2 rebounds, playing with 2 personal fouls. Halfway call, love to do this, watch him. And Juan Fernandez is crashing the board. So far, 11 defensive rebounds, plus 3 offense. Blau, nothing there in the second attempt, but Arnaiz, oh, he lost it to Fabiosa, just put it away from his hand. And there's a crash foul.
Fabiosa waiting a little bit too long to make the pass to Gidabin. Fernandez waiting in good position.
16 in the middle six. Gavin hit 12 points and pulled out 12 behind, 6 and 6.
Again, the foul shooting killing the Toyota ball club.
After this match, win or lose, I think Edo Campos will ask all of his players to line up one after another, build a free line for 1 week.
Yes, and whoever misses the foul shot is forced to run some laps.
This happens every school day. It's 7 and 20. 1 point game being enjoyed by Crispa. Stretched further by Billy Ray Bates. He's alive and well. After making 23 in the first three quarters, another 7 for a total of 30 so far. By the way, after this match comes our regular feature, Cross the Inside Basketball. And our topic for tonight is on resolution of time. Don't miss it. Billy Ray Bates. Game with 6:50 to go. 99-54. Crispa, and there's a foul called against Billy Ray Bates. That's his third.
Now Bates has to be very careful. They have already given him a warning. And if he just opens his mouth, says anything, the referees are going to give him a technical. Well, the way Toyota's shooting from the free throw line, I don't know how much of an advantage that really is.
Juan Fernandez rushing from him, called against the big J. He is now in trouble. It's a five personnel foul. We have a timeout. We'll be right back. Time left 6:35 with Crispa on top by 5 points, 99-94. We would like to remind all PBA fans that starting Sunday, July 3rd, the PBA games will be covered nationwide on radio by the Voice of the Philippines, which is 918 KHZ on your radio dials. On Cesar, back again to him. Billy Ray Bates, low posting. Cesar was already trapped, but he was able to get the basket.
And it's a very tough shot. The defense of Toyota was concentrated around really Billy Ray Bates, and they took the ball right in.
Now you can see the power, the consistent power of Crispa Redmanizer. They've been moving slowly but surely forward. They're top 101, 94 Toyota. Juan Fernandez looking for room, straight shot.
Yes, that was an isolation play from Juan Fernandez. Keep the middle open and let Juan Fernandez wheel and deal.
First quarter won by Toyota by 1 point, and then they came out even in the second. And the third, it was Crispa by 2, 28-26. Good basket coming from Billy Ray Bates. Now he's been attacking 34 points.
You know, usually you expect spectacular points from Billy Ray Bates. Tonight, they've done just in regular points. He's come up with 34 of them.
Is going through. Nothing. A little bit short. And they go to Varela. Give it to him. Varela with one of his high games this year. 7 points. Career high. 7 points. That's the reason as to why Tommy Morata has kept him. Not only because he's been scoring, but he's been playing rugged defense. He's been pounding Arnaiz. And Toyota throws it away. Well, now he's pulled up by Edo Campo. Now is the time, and this is the right time. Yes, go this way.
Yes, and this is a very crucial moment now for Toyota. They're down by 9 points. The third quarter shooting statistics, Crispa 48%, Toyota only 42.
Dorsey is playing with five personnel fouls. King and Juan Fernandez at three apiece. Israel's got three. Four, incidentally. And we have a traveling call. Call against Crispa. We have a turnover. Timeout. We'll be right back. Time less 4:39. And we have a foul called against Varela. That is his fourth personal foul. No, it is a foul called against Padim Israel. Fourth personal foul. We have leading scorers, Steve.
Okay, for Toyota, it's not their import. It's the local player, Juan Fernandez, 35 points. Bates, 34 for the Redmanizer. Tennessee Atoy, Carl Phil Cesar, 14, 13, 12. King, 23. Pencil Sunrise, 10. Julius Swain with 10 points. I think what has happened to the Redmanizer, to the Toyota team, is that the players that are on the court were just wore down. Abe King playing almost the entire ball game. Same held true for Juan Fernandez and Francis Arnaiz. Whereas for the Redmanizers, Manotas was bringing players in and out of the game.
Here's Arnaiz getting nothing from the line, and Philip Cesar just pulled down his sixth rebound. That's true, Steve, because Edo Campo just skipped a nucleus in the game.
Yes, just about six or seven players were getting playing time for El Campo, whereas Tommy Manotas used nine players with
second team foul. Six already called against Crispa. We are under 4 minutes. Here is Varela.
It is counted. This is a new card being surfaced here by Varela.
Team 5.